Hello, it's Polish Paul VR and welcome to the Lost Bear review. So, the Lost Bear is the game where you play as a little girl trying to find her teddy bear, which was stolen by an evil toy snatcher because he is a teddy bear creature. And that's the story which you're gonna play through. But I remember when the game first got announced, talking to the developers, and they told me that the game been inspired by a lead designer little sister who disappeared into the woods playing without telling the family and then just came back at the end of the day like nothing ever happened, and the game is an imagination on what she did in the woods that day. And let me tell you what a great imagination that is. All of the world feels so well designed, with art style being just beautiful. It's like watching moving painting while listening to nice relaxing soundtrack and of course the various sound coming out of the woods. Each level looks and sounds great, with the perfectly balanced colors and beautifully drawn environments. And even though you're sitting on a chair and watching world in front of you on a giant theater screen, it is deeply immersive, and let me tell you that the things can fly out of that theater screen at your face as well, and interaction with the room you're sitting in will impact on the game further into the story. There is a few puzzle elements here and there, and even killing the enemies can be a puzzle itself. It felt a bit like Oddworld, the game which I loved to play when I was a little boy. But apart from puzzles and platforming, there is some action sequences as well, and during them the pace of the game will pick up a bit. It feels great, but you need to have quick reflexes, as it is easy to die in this game. Which is fair enough, but every time you die, the whole level will load the game. And that's my only complaint, as loading times in VR feels like forever. When you sit with your headset on and just doing nothing, waiting for game to load. So, control-wise, this game plays using DualShocks. Controls are fairly simple, just few buttons. But your controller is tracked as well and will operate various mechanisms by movement. They're definitely easy to get used to and won't be a nuisance. Now, the length-wise, the developers was honest with us from the beginning. They said the game will take about an hour to finish, and you get in 5 chapters about 10 minutes long. Depends on how fast you solve your puzzles and how many times you die. It should take you about an hour for your first playthrough, and after that, after you finish the game, there is a chapter select as well. So the game seems to be priced appropriately for what you're getting. So, even though I received the key for the game, I would not regret buying it. It's a shame that it's so short, but oh well, what can you do? I still had a blast playing it. I think I just played with a smile on my face all the way through the game. So, just to finish, I like to always say, would I recommend it or would I not recommend it, or would I advise to wait for sale? So, with this game, I can 100% recommend it for you. It's a great game, you will have great time. It comes out soon. Once it's out, go and grab it, and you will have an hour well spent. So, that's it for my review. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, I'm very happy about it, and I'll be back.